make us some smothered steaks or gravy steaks. I've made them before and call them smothered round steak. But I'm not using round today. I'm going to use a cut off the shoulder, which is even more tender than the round steak is. And you don't have to cook it as long. And it's real damn good. First, I want to just tell everybody Merry Christmas. I'm over my little episode, and it's going to be my first cooking video in a couple of weeks. And I don't have any mistletoe, but I got this just as a simulation. You know how you usually hang mistletoe up so that all the good-looking babes come by and supposed to give you a kiss, hanging over your head like that? You're using the wrong head. Look here. Hang it down here. Over that head like that. Oops. Yeah, hang it down here. That way you get a kiss on the right head. Use your head, boy, for something other than a hat rack, huh? Boy, look, I got the cheat. For those who know what the cheat is, it's a website, homestarrunner.com, and it's a pretty good children's website. It's a lot better than some of the garbage they got on TV. It's animated, and the cheat is one of the characters there, and he's abused on the website, and he's really a nice little guy, and this one's got a talk box in it, and they'd like to kick him on the website. So every time you hit him or kick him, the talk box makes this sound. And that's the cheat's voice. Pretty cool, huh? So, let's go ahead and get started with these steaks. It's going to be gravy with rice and steak and mistletoe. Close to my toes. This is what's known as Southern comfort food. And we've got these little steaks in here, and we're going to get some of the, little bit of the fat off of them. And, but we're going to cook that fat in there with them. But I'm going to separate it off to where I can pull it out easier after the fact, boy. So let me get done, and this is USDA Choice Angus beef, and this is cut from the, it's either the shoulder or the chuck. I think it's from the chuck, what the butcher told me, because I asked. You know how inquisitive minds we want to know. So here's our skillet that we're going to use. I'm going to go ahead and put some salt in the bottom of it. I'm going to show you why. And a little bit of black pepper. And we're going to put that meat right there on top of that. And that's going to season the bottom side of it. Amazing, huh? So these are the little strips that I'm going to cut. You're going to have to do this in stages. Because this is a lot of steak that this is going to make. Save them fatty pieces for your dogs, and they'll really love you. And now we're going to go ahead and season the top side of them with some salt. Use plenty of salt because you're going to have a lot of gravy with this that you got to have over your rice. You don't need a whole lot of pepper though. We don't put too much of that. You want to use Cajun seasoning on here? Do it. I don't care. Salt and pepper. Let's go get this batch. I'm going to put some Earl in there. And let's go get this batch started browning. We want to get a good brown color on. And this is what you want to see. Nice brown meat. You want to get it good and brown because that's what's going to make this gravy. See there? Flip them over. Brown them on the other side. And don't forget the little pieces for the dogs. Got them kind of nestled over in that corner. There's one. So here we're gonna brown all this meat down over here. And there's the dog food right over there, the fat. There's a couple of pieces left in here. They're good enough. Pull them out. That's good. Let's chunk some onions in here. Just rough chop up, who cares? Watch what's gonna happen here. This is like magic. Rocket science, building nuclear submarines. Put them all in there. This is one large onion. And we're gonna sweat this down. Talk about gonna be fine. There's your magic right there. See them onions, how they brown? That ain't from cooking them to death. That's from all the moisture that they release and the flan from the bottom of the pan. Now let's go ahead and put this meat in there. And I got some more, another batch. I gotta get up in here too. And we're gonna add just some water. That's it. Simple, simple Cajun cooking at its finest. And we're gonna let this sit here and simmer with the water. You can put wine, you don't have to. We don't normally do that. We just cook, eat over rice with the gravy, boy. Now I'm not gonna add no browning sauce. We're just gonna let that water do its thing in there. And it's gonna release all them bits, them brown bits off that meat. And yeah, you could put bell peppers in here. You could put celery. You put any damn thing you want to. That's what cooking's about. I already told y'all that. If y'all don't know, just stay stupid. And this is a fine meal right here. You can thicken this gravy up many, many different ways. I'm gonna get my mistletoe back out.
Test 1, 2, 3. Obviously, these first 10 are breakfast, with the latter being Mexican style breakfast. There's eggs up underneath them beans and rices and sauces and things. I forget how you call it. It's how you call it Mexican breakfast. And naturally, then pizza. And then it after the barbecue, it's going to get a little tougher. If you can correctly guess what these are, you'll get an attaboy. Only one attaboy per video is allowed. And collect enough attaboys, and I'll think of something that you'll get for free.